So class activity, so your one program will be given, the program of the textbook, the program of the Wipro company, what he has asked, and I will have to explain the problem definition first, and then we start to solve it. And do not make hurry, take your time to solve it. It is the class activity. You are free to discuss among your classmates by this meeting only. That also will be recorded. You are free to discuss by chat or what. And finally, the answer is in 5-6 lines only, the code. So that you can, after successful execution, you can show your code either in the chat box. Better to show. So that will be recorded as your class activity you have participated. So, or it will be academic record also. So you will not say that I was present, but mic was not working. Mic is not working, so chat box is working. And certainly the first 5 persons who are answering that in the chat box after taking the time 10 or 20 minutes, so that will be getting the first 5 persons getting that full marks. And the problem will be visible to you because I'm going to start presentation now. So that screen has been shared to you. Anyone will see it is visible?
Yes, sir.
Fine. In class activity, it is the problem statement from the textbook. I am reading it out, then I will be explaining the problem. And it is not like that some timeout based questions. You can snap the question also from the screen to discuss and think that how this problem can be solved. And it is simple one loop problem, not even the nested loop, only to understand the problem. And taken from the textbook, reference is also from that placement companies. So write a function named call at Z. I'm not calling it call as, call at Z, that has one parameter named number. So that one function is getting one argument as number. If number is even, then it is just printing the number and return this value. If number is odd, then it is printing what? 3 multiplied by number plus 1. I repeat, if number is even, just it prints the number and return its value. If number is odd, then it's printing and returning 3 multiplied by number plus 1. Is it like that? So what happens? So this is running in a loop, that what number you have taken, that lets the user type in an integer, and that keeps calling the call, so that function will be called in a loop. Up to what time, sir? So this will be called from the loop till that function is not returning 1. I repeat, the function will be called. The function, what the function is doing? If it is even number, then it is printing the number and return. I am missing some question or what? I will see that. Number, I think one thing I am missing. Not only the number \2 that was missing. Sorry. You know that the \2 means what? Anyone will respond? \2 is what? And the \2 means the number is divided by 2 and it returns the integer value. Yes, if it is the even number, certainly it will be returning the even value. Sorry, it will be returning the integer value and return this value. If number is odd, then this function is returning 3 multiplied by number plus 1. So simple a function is there, receiving a number, and that number is even, then it is returning \2, means the floor division integer value. And if this value, and if it is odd number, then it is returning 3 multiplied by number plus 1. Now, when this function is called within a loop, taking a number, you are running a loop, and the loop will be running and running and running. till that number is not returning one. When it will return one, then the loop will be terminated. And you will be surprised to know, so amazingly enough, this sequence, just I am taking the fun, they actually works for any integer. Sooner or later, after 100 times of the loop, lastly, it will have to return one. So using this sequence, you will arrive at one. Even the mathematicians are not sure why. Your program is exploring what is called the call at Z sequence, sometimes called what? The simplest impossible math problem. The simplest impossible math problem. What is the expected output you see here? So you have entered the 37. So, okay. And 37 is written here two times. So 37. And if it is odd number, what it is returning? 3 multiplied by number plus 1. And again, in which way the function is called again, that number is passed, again that number is passed, and this loop is executing and executing and executing. And when that function is returning one, at that time loop will terminate. The another I have tried with the other odd number, 23. So 23 multiplied by 3, 69 plus 1, 70. And again, in which way it is passed, and again, and again, and again, and again. And finally, the loop is terminated when it is giving one. So write a program that lets the user type an integer and that keeps the calling call at Z function on that number until the function returns the value one. Amazingly enough, this sequence actually works for any integer. Sooner or later, using this sequence, we will arrive at one. Even mathematicians are not sure why. Your program is exploring what is called the call at Z sequence, sometimes called the simplest impossible math problem. So now the meeting is yours. You are free for the group discussion, code, and execute. The problem is lying before you. Is it visible again, Marin?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that I will be keeping it visible. The problem definition and expected output, like the placement question, it is given. So that it is not like that when you are getting this program on the net and giving the solution at fast. You will have to explain it also, writing that. You can write that particular code having the 5-6 line of code only, and then write in the chat box, taking care of the indent and so the execution, and explain that program. If you are able to explain, anyone can unmute the, if you have solved, unmute your mic and discuss and that explain that particular in which way, because the solution is very easy. And at last, at the end of the class, I will be sending the solution to you. Okay. You have taken the snap of the problem. Now 50 people already joined.
Could you show the question again?
Okay.
Yes, sir. Done.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
The meeting is yours. And you can enjoy the rest of your time if you are typing the solution in your chat box. And then you can leave it. If you want to present it, you can present or you can leave it. Okay. So here I am switching my mic off.
Done, sir. So do we paste the code in the chat?
हेलो पात्रा, ओए पात्रा, हेलो।
हाँ अरे हाँ बोल।
क्वेश्चन क्या है?
देखना स्क्रीन में ही है।
अरे बोलना।
अबे एक फंक्शन लिख, अगर कोलाप्स करके फंक्शन है तो पैरामीटर एक नंबर इंटीजर लेगा जो तू यूजर से ले रहा है एन, ठीक है। अगर वो एन इवन हुआ तो वो रिटर्न करेगा एन डबल स्लैश टू एन एब्सोल्यूट डिवीजन टू, जो खाली क्वेश्चन रिटर्न करते हैं। अगर ऑड है तो थ्री टाइम्स एन प्लस वन रिटर्न करेगा, और ये फंक्शन तेरे को तब तक रन करना जब तक एन का वैल्यू वन ना हो।
तो क्या एन को माइनस वन करना है, मतलब हर बार एक बार?
नहीं, वो तेरा फंक्शन ही तेरा एन वन हो जाएगा, वो जो एन मॉड टू और एन उसे हो रहा है ना
ठीक है
उसे, तो वो चीज को ही तो वाइल एन ग्रेटर देन वन तक कर हो जाएगा।
मतलब n इक्वल टू n डबल स्लैश स्लैश टू और n इक्वल टू थ्री n, थ्री n प्लस वन, है ना? ठीक है ठीक है। और कुछ तो नहीं है ना इसमें?
नहीं नहीं सिंपल।
So now, hello. Anyone please respond?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that what you have done, that is already recorded. I am very much pleased that you have here only you are printing. Okay, printing and returning here only. Okay. That result is not equal to one. It may be greater than one also. Anyway, printing or returning or returning or printing. Printing or returning or returning or printing. Here the indentation part is missing. No, not required. Here you have written this one, n multiplied by 3, else this one. N double equal to 1, that is jigger. Jigger, please talk to me, jigger.
Yes, sir.
Even number and odd number, how will check that? N percentage to double equal to 0 or 1. Hello? Jigger, if you are listening, yes, please respond.
Yes, sir.
If number is odd and even, how you are checking?
So if n and 1, then it is odd. Otherwise, it
n
is even.
N percentage 2 double equal to 0, then it is even. If it is not, so this logic what you have written, I am not getting. N double equal to 1, return what? Nothing. Function is not written correctly, Jigar. I think he has written Vasim. Has written Ishita Chattopadhyay. Done, sir. Okay. Kirti. So I'm asking the attendance so that he or she is present or not, and we'll conclude that class now. So first stopping the sharing of the screen. And now here, tell me that Harsh Dhiman is there. Harsh Dhiman. Harsh Dhiman, Harsh Dut, Harsh Dhiman, Harsh Dut, one more H, what I was telling, Harsh Dhiman, Harsh Dut, and Hardik. All these three are not there. So we will not say that attendance. Vishnu Vardhan and Ajahn is not there. Hemant is not there. Ramya is there. My mentee Ramya, please. I am asking Ramya. Ramya is not there. Harsh Dut, Harsh Dhiman, Hardik is not there. Yasha is there. Yasha is there. Vani is there. Vani is not there. So today many people absent. Vani is not there. Nikita, how are you, Nikita? Nikita Ishwarna?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Monica? Monica, respond to me. Isha Malnir? Isha, please. Isha is there. Okay, Nitin N? Nitin N, I am not seeing your name alphabetically. Nitin N? Nitin N, yes, he is there. Nitin is there, Shreya is there. Okay, fine. Omkar is there. So I just repeating the names, I'm not finding this name. Harsh Dhiman, Harsh Dut, Hardik. Still he is absent. Vishnu, Vardhan Reddy, Ajahn, Hemant, Ramya, Vani. And now stopping the recording.